Hi, this is Jim Lipuma of the New Jersey Institute of Technology, recording for my course, Technical Communications, with material drawn from my text, Fundamentals of Undergraduate Education and Learning. Today, we're furthering our discussion of making definitions by looking at valid versus good and why both are important. So the first thing we want to understand is that when we're making definitions, defining things helps us reduce the you know what I mean for our target. But more importantly, if you have a clear understanding of what it is you mean by these words, it increases the likelihood you'll be able to use words effectively. Now, it's more than just words. Even though I use this as our beginning point, what you want to realize is that these discussions we have about defining things can be larger than just how a word is used. It can be a situation that you're defining. It can be your target or group of targets, your goal. Any of the things we're talking about come back to this clear idea of having a picture of what it is you want to say and what you want to do in your own mind. For us, this clear message is important for making the sender know what they want to say and the target understand it as it is meant to be said. Definitions help clarify your thinking. Hopefully, if you are able to improve the quality of your critical thinking, the speed at which you can improve the clarification of your message will increase as well. So for us, what you want to see is that this is at the heart of everything that's come before, which has been an introduction toward this core idea of technical communication, the idea of you as a sender making choices to clearly define what you want to say, achieve for a specified target in a specified situation. However, it will also lead us into the remainder of the course in which we will look at specific instances that we will be using packages to accomplish goals for technical communication. We'll move forward after this presentation into some specific examples to help explain this, and then at the end of the course, we'll look at specific rhetoric situations in which packages have to be created in forms that are given to you or that are generally accepted, such as your resume, cover letter, emails, memos, proposals, PowerPoint presentations, interviews, and the like. So let's move forward. Our first thing is, how are definitions used? Definitions are really the clear statement of the boundaries and parameters given to an item, a group, or a situation. For us, these parameters are important because they help clarify examples and categories. For us, an example is simply a single representative of an item or an instance of something. And so anything can be an example, but that doesn't tell us anything because the example is tied to a group in which that example is a representative member thereof. So then, what is that group called? Well, we consider that a category. A category is any group of similar items that are tied together by a relationship or a characteristic. As the sender, it's important for you to identify the groups and categories that exist already. Or if they don't exist for your particular situation to meet your goal, you then have to define them. And for us, defining these categories is key to understanding good definitions and clearly creating your package. So why do we have this idea of both valid and good definitions? For us, effective definitions are both valid and good. What do we mean by that? Well, the first thing you have to realize is that in both cases, for clear and valid definitions, we want to see that clear limits are set, that you draw a line in your mind around a group of items, and you specify what fits within that circle and what is outside of that. So for us, these clear limits help us understand what it is we're talking about. In the same way, as you use words, you want to understand the context and situation because those limits of the context in which will be used and the situation will be used helps make the definition clearer and thus valid. So what does that mean? So valid definitions for us follow the four rules to help reduce ambiguity. Good definitions are those that set the limits of the category so that everything you as a center want to include is within those boundaries, and everything that you want to exclude or keep out is kept out. In this way, there is a clear delineation between things that belong and things that don't belong as you see it, so that as you pass that package on to your target, they will see it in the way that you do. going a little bit further, we have to really think about this idea of word use, because word usage is at the heart of good definitions, good packages, and all communication. The effective package uses the right words, the ones that are appropriate and that the target will understand in the way you wish them to understand it. A little further from this, you want to know your goal, target, and situation in order to select the correct words. If you don't know these different areas, it's very difficult to know that you've picked the right words. Now, making clear distinctions is very important. The distinctions between words can many times be difficult. If you don't know that there is a difference, but your target does recognize these words to be different, then your package can lose its effectiveness. So what you want to do is you want to consider how others might interpret what you're saying, because their perception of the words from their perspective may change how they see and use the word you're trying to say. This will become much more evident as we go through examples in the next few presentations. Thank you.